The sun has been a blinding mystery for most of human history because its overwhelming brightness prevented direct study. It was an untouchable light in the sky that sustained life on Earth, often seen as a divine or supernatural force. Fast forward to today, and we can observe the sun in great detail, layer by layer, capturing every little feature. And in today's video, we will be doing exactly that. To study the sun in greater detail, we must first eliminate the scattering effects caused by Earth's atmosphere. Astronauts aboard the International Space Station, positioned above the atmosphere, have a clearer and unobstructed view of the sun. This is where we see its true color, white. It appears as a perfectly defined, radiant sphere, much sharper than it looks from Earth, set against the stark blackness of space. However, its details are still invisible to the naked eye. To study the sun more deeply, we must understand how light works. The sun emits various types of light, including visible and invisible forms, such as ultraviolet, infrared, and radio waves. These different types of light originate from distinct regions of the sun. However, the visible light is so bright that it overwhelms the fainter types. By filtering out some of the intense visible light, scientists can focus on the dimmer emissions and observe more details about the sun's structure and activity. This is precisely what the Solar Dynamics Observatory was designed to accomplish. Launched on February 11, 2010, SDO is a space telescope that continuously observes the sun, capturing images and data across multiple wavelengths of light. Let's look at the sun using the 19.3 nanometer wavelength, which falls within the extreme ultraviolet range. This wavelength is crucial for observing the sun's corona, the outermost layer of its atmosphere that extends millions of kilometers into space. The corona envelops the sun's more defined, visible sphere. At temperatures of 1 to 3 million degrees Celsius, the corona is dramatically hotter than the sun's surface, which is approximately 5,500 degrees Celsius. This temperature disparity is one of the greatest mysteries in solar physics. One of the most prominent features of the corona is the presence of dark regions called coronal holes. These areas appear dark because they are cooler and less dense than the surrounding parts of the corona. In coronal holes, the sun's magnetic field is open, meaning the magnetic field lines stretch outward into space instead of looping back to the sun's surface, as they do in other regions. This open configuration allows solar wind to escape more freely into space, reaching speeds of up to 800 kilometers per second. When the solar wind from a coronal hole reaches Earth, it interacts with Earth's magnetosphere, producing the colorful displays known as auroras. In addition to creating these stunning auroras, Earth's magnetosphere acts as a protective shield. Without it, the solar wind could strip away Earth's atmosphere and expose the surface to harmful solar radiation. Mars, however, lacks a magnetosphere, which has allowed the solar wind to strip away much of its atmosphere over time, leading to the loss of most of its potential liquid water. This presents a significant challenge for Mars' habitability, making the planet inhospitable to life as we know it. Returning to the sun, let's observe it using the 9.4 nanometer wavelength. The intensely bright, localized bursts of light visible here are solar flares. These flares release energy equivalent to millions of hydrogen bombs exploding simultaneously and typically last from a few minutes to several hours. These powerful bursts of energy occur on the sun's surface because its magnetic fields, over time, store vast amounts of energy as they stretch and twist, similar to tension building in a rubber band. Eventually, these fields can snap or reconfigure, releasing the stored energy in an explosive event. Now, let's examine the sun using the 30.4 nanometer wavelength on the electromagnetic spectrum. At this wavelength, we can observe solar prominences, large, bright, and often loop-shaped structures of plasma extending outward from the sun's surface into the corona. These prominences form because the sun's magnetic fields create loops that bubble up through the surface, trapping plasma and guiding it along the arcs. Despite the sun's intense gravity pulling the plasma downward, the magnetic fields act like an invisible net, holding the plasma in place and giving it the appearance of floating in the corona. Solar prominences can float in the atmosphere for days, weeks, or even months. Eventually, similar to solar flares, a magnetic reconnection can occur, or the magnetic fields may become unstable. This instability can cause the prominence to erupt, releasing billions of tons of energy into space in an event known as a coronal mass ejection. These solar prominences can reach unimaginable sizes, sometimes dozens of times larger than Earth. While the plasma of a solar prominence appears bright against the darkness of space, it looks darker and denser when viewed against the corona. This contrast arises because the corona is hundreds of times hotter than the plasma originating from the sun's surface. Continuing with the same wavelength, we can observe another stunning phenomenon, coronal rain. In this process, plasma rises from the sun's surface into the corona along magnetic field lines. Although this plasma is hundreds of times cooler than the corona, it cools further because the corona has an extremely low particle density. The plasma is too dense to absorb significant heat, while it loses much more heat by radiating light. As the plasma cools and becomes denser, gravity eventually overpowers the magnetic forces holding it aloft, making it too heavy to remain suspended. This creates the mesmerizing phenomenon of coronal rain that you can see here. Interestingly, the corona and its features, including those we've just discussed, can be observed with the naked eye during a total solar eclipse. During this event, the moon passes directly between Earth and the sun, completely covering the sun's bright photosphere and revealing the corona. The photosphere is about a million times brighter than the corona. Therefore, when the photosphere is covered, the faint light of the corona becomes visible. Now let's look deeper into the sun. Using the 170 nanometer wavelength, we can observe the chromosphere, the last distinct layer before reaching the surface. The chromosphere can also be seen during a total solar eclipse, appearing as a thin reddish ring around the sun. This layer is approximately 2,000 to 3,000 kilometers thick, depending on solar activity. Temperatures in the chromosphere are closer to those on the surface, ranging from about 6,000 to 25,000 Kelvin. The chromosphere is populated with about 10 million spicules, small, jet-like structures of plasma that rise and fall, extending into the upper layers of the atmosphere. When viewed in profile against the sun's limb, these spicules appear as fine, grass-like structures. These spicules typically extend 5,000 to 10,000 kilometers above the chromosphere and have diameters ranging from about 200 to 500 kilometers. Spicules are short-lived, with an average lifespan of 5 to 10 minutes. Plasma within spicules moves at supersonic speeds of 20 to 100 kilometers per second. In some cases, this material is ejected into the corona, while in others, it falls back toward the surface. Until 2017, the rapid and frequent formation of spicules and their ability to shoot plasma into the sun's atmosphere at such high speeds remained a mystery. The key missing piece was the role of neutral particles, which had often been overlooked in solar models. When scientists included neutral particles in their simulations, they discovered that these particles reduced the stickiness between magnetic fields and plasma. This reduction makes it easier for energy to escape, enabling the rapid formation of spicules. Another fascinating feature of the chromosphere is solar tornadoes. Despite their name, solar tornadoes are not like those on Earth, which result from differences in air pressure. Instead, solar tornadoes form due to twisted magnetic fields on the sun. These magnetic fields trap and guide charged particles, causing them to spiral along the magnetic field lines. These structures are enormous. A solar tornado can reach tens of thousands of kilometers in height, sometimes large enough to fit several Earths inside. The plasma in these solar tornadoes rotates at speeds of up to 100,000 kilometers per hour. The bright areas visible around sunspots are known as plages. Plages are dense regions in the chromosphere of the sun, typically located in active regions where magnetic activity is strongest. They appear brighter than the surrounding chromosphere due to localized heating, which can reach temperatures of up to 20,000 Kelvin. Plages can cover vast areas, often extending tens of thousands of kilometers across. Finally, at the 617.3 nanometer wavelength, we reach the photosphere, the last layer before light escapes into space. The photosphere is the sun's visible surface, the layer from which most of the sunlight we see is emitted. Although it takes light just 8 minutes and 20 seconds to travel the 150 million kilometers between the Sun and Earth, its journey from the Sun's core to the photosphere takes tens of thousands of years. Despite being the layer that emits most of the Sun's visible light, the photosphere is relatively thin, with a depth of only about 500 kilometers. It is not solid. It is a layer of hot, glowing plasma, composed primarily of hydrogen and helium, along with traces of oxygen, carbon, iron, and so on. The temperature of the photosphere ranges from approximately 6,000 to 4,500 Kelvin. When observed under high magnification, the photosphere has a granular appearance. These granules are the result of convection currents of hot plasma rising and cooler plasma sinking. Each granule is about 1,000 kilometers across and lasts for 5 to 10 minutes. The bright centers represent rising hot material, while the darker edges indicate cooler material sinking back down. These horizontal plasma flows can move faster than the local sound speed, which is approximately 7 to 10 kilometers per second. These supersonic flows can generate shockwaves that propagate through the solar plasma. The dark regions visible on the photosphere are sunspots. They are caused by intense magnetic fields that disrupt the normal convection of heat. Sunspots can persist for days to months. With temperatures around 3,000 to 4,500 Kelvin, sunspots are cooler than the surrounding photosphere because the magnetic fields inhibit the upward flow of hot plasma. Around the edges of sunspots, granules may appear distorted or elongated as the magnetic field influences plasma motion. Plasma flows outward from the center of the sunspot at supersonic speeds. Sunspots are located in the same regions where solar flares occur, as observed when comparing photosphere images to those of the corona. This is because sunspots are part of active regions, where magnetic fields are most intense. These magnetic fields can snap and reconnect, releasing massive amounts of energy. Unlike a solid body, the Sun exhibits differential rotation, meaning different parts of the Sun rotate at different speeds. The Sun's equator rotates faster than its poles, completing a rotation in approximately 25 days, while the poles take about 35 days. This differential rotation plays a crucial role in the solar dynamo, the mechanism that generates the Sun's magnetic field. The interaction between rotation and convection twists and amplifies magnetic field lines, leading to phenomena such as sunspots, solar flares, and coronal mass ejections. The photosphere is the deepest layer of the Sun that we can observe directly. We cannot see deeper because the Sun's interior is too dense and opaque for light to escape. The photosphere is the layer where light becomes free to travel into space, making it the visible surface of the Sun. But still, once shrouded in mystery, the Sun is now a well-studied celestial body, thanks to advancements in technology. Scientists have captured the Sun's activity across a variety of wavelengths, layer by layer, observing phenomena such as coronal holes, solar flares, prominences, and sunspots. This knowledge has greatly enhanced our understanding of events like the solar wind and coronal mass ejections, which can impact Earth's atmosphere and technology. Additionally, this research allows us to better predict space weather and gain insight into the evolution of planets like Mars. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and subscribe to Lucid Space if you want to see more.